When you picture Wisconsin, you might think of beer or dairies or the Lake Michigan shoreline. But would you think of incredible fossils that are hundreds of millions of years old? You should.
When you picture a fossil, you probably think of something like this. A gigantic skeleton of a prehistoric beast, like a dinosaur or a mastodon. These skeletons are on display at the University of Wisconsin Geology Museum. Carrie Eaton is the museum's curator. Some of her most popular exhibits are preserved bones.
What we're seeing mostly is the bone. And over time, that bone is transformed from that organic material into something that's much more mineral. And it's those hard parts that are preserved. That's what we typically see.
But lots of living things don't have hard parts like shells or bones. Fossils of soft-bodied creatures are extremely rare, but they have been found. One of the most remarkable discoveries in paleontology was made here at a quarry in Waukesha, Wisconsin, just west of Milwaukee. It was here in 1984 that amateur paleontologists and avid collectors Ron Meyer and Jerry Gunderson came to dig for fossils.
A fellow collector who was with the Wisconsin Geological Survey showed us a slab like this full of trilobites, and it blew our mind. And we said, "Where did you get that?" He said, "Oh, we were on a field trip to this quarry in Waukesha. Man, we were motivated because we've never seen anything like that." So the next weekend, we were off to this quarry, and there was this very thin layer of rock that was largely dark and had varving, which are little lines would indicate that it had been set down in multiple times, and it split. And I opened it up, and I saw this animal, which we call the halgramite animal. And it was a beautiful, soft-bodied creature that nobody had ever seen before. And I said, "Jerry, come over here quickly." And Lee said, "Oh my God, this is amazingly significant. We gotta collect this site."
The fossils were from the Silurian period, which ended more than 150 million years before the first dinosaurs appeared.
The Silurian is a period of geologic time, and the Silurian layers in Wisconsin were laid down between 440 and 415 million years ago. And during that period of time, most of the state was covered by this large ocean.
It was a truly remarkable find and a thrilling moment.
We were so excited, we couldn't believe that we had actually found a Lagerstätten, as it turned out. A Lagerstätten is a fossil site that's preserved the whole ecosystem. It was like the wildest dream any fossil collector could ever want. You couldn't get any better than this.
But at the moment of discovery, there was little time to celebrate. The pressure was on to collect the fossils before it was too late.
Now, this was an active quarry, so parts of this layer were actually going to be blasted. And so over the course of months, they went out and continued to collect this material to salvage it and save it for research and science.
Thousands of fossils recovered from the quarry are now housed here at the University of Wisconsin Geology Museum in Madison.
These are the specimens of the Waukesha biota that we have on display here in our museum. I really like this leech fossil because it looks exactly like what you would expect it to look like. In particular, if you look very closely, you can actually see the little individual segmented rings on the leech's body, and even its mouth parts are preserved. This is an early Wisconsin resident. One of the neat things about these fossils that come from the areas around where we live is that these animals were swimming around in an ocean that are now our backyards and streets and sidewalks today.
The most mysterious thing about these fossils is how they were preserved in the first place. When an animal dies and is buried by sediment, its soft parts are rarely preserved. Hard parts of animals most commonly become fossils by petrification, permineralization, or replacement, all processes in which water leaves behind minerals, gradually transforming hard parts like bones and teeth into a stone-like material.
In the case of the Waukesha, the preservation was a little bit different. And because of that style of preservation, we could see soft parts. And those soft parts include soft tissues of the animals, and they also include some of the internal structures.
This different process of preservation is considered exceptional or extraordinary preservation, and it's the reason the Waukesha fossils were in the quarry waiting to be dug up.
The difference between exceptional preservation and a more typical fossil preservation would mean the difference between getting to see this leech fossil and seeing nothing at all. So when these were first found, it was a pretty remarkable find. And at the time, it was unknown what conditions led to this kind of preservation. Well, research suggests that the preservation was actually highly aided by the presence of microbes.
Back during the Silurian period, and sometimes even today, tiny beings formed what are known as microbial mats. These are communities of microorganisms that form in layers, and we have them to thank for preservation of the Waukesha fossils.
This large column is a Winogradsky column, and these types of columns were developed as a way to study groups of bacteria and how they interact with each other. What's neat about this column is that the bacteria living inside it are actually from the same groups of bacteria that would have been living in microbial mats on Earth 3 billion years ago.
You might have heard of the green stuff at the top of the column. It's cyanobacteria.
When we think of cyanobacteria today, we tend to think of the more problematic kinds, like the blue-green algae that we have to look out for in our lakes and waterways. But when the first cyanobacteria appeared on Earth about 2.8 billion years ago, they started producing oxygen, and it's because of that cyanobacteria that we have an oxygenated atmosphere that we can live in. We owe a lot to cyanobacteria.
It's microbial mats like the one in this column that preserved the creatures we now see in the Waukesha fossils since the Silurian period.
They were getting stuck to these microbial mat surfaces, and that actually aided in their preservation. Sediment would also stick on top of them, and then those microbes would actually aid in the precipitation of minerals, and those minerals would create a hard film that would help to preserve those animals for hundreds of millions of years.
The skeletons of dinosaurs and mastodons are dramatic, but on their own, they only tell part of the story. But the truth is that most life on Earth has been composed of soft tissue, and fossils like these, preserved by microbes, help expand our view of our region's prehistoric past.
That exceptional preservation shows you soft parts of animals that you otherwise wouldn't see any remnants of whatsoever. And this gives us a much larger picture of what life was like in Wisconsin and the upper Midwest during this period of time.
At Great Lakes Now, we aim to cover the Great Lakes region and the people who live here, like you. Please follow us on social media, subscribe to our YouTube channel, and sign up for our newsletter at greatlakesnow.org.